Now that you know the basic layout of our studio, you're welcome to customize it by going to Tools and then Options. From here, you can change the default directory if you'd like. You can change formatting options for editing code, or you can even change the font and the appearance. Here, I'm using the Tamara theme, but there are of course some others. You can also make adjustments to the panes, so feel free to play around with this to get a configuration that you like. Now, you might not have any idea what you like first, so just wait until you play with R a bit, and then you'll find a configuration that suits you. I'm going to leave this as is. All right, we've got R set up, so let's start using the programming language. To get started, I want you to download the R script from the instructor notes and open it here. When you open the file, it should look like this. This R script contains both comments as plain text and R code. You can run R commands by highlighting a chunk of the code and then hitting Command and Enter on a Mac or Control Enter on a PC. The lines of text that start with a hash or a pound symbol are comments. These lines are plain text that we don't run around as R code. It's the standalone text that you really want for the R code. Now, your task is to read through this file and run and write code when you're prompted to do so. When you get to the end of the file, you'll get to a question, and you'll need to answer this question to move on to the next video in this lesson. Now, if you're already familiar with R, I suggest trying to answer the questions, and then you might want to go back to the files to see if you missed anything. We know you learn best by doing, so it's important that you execute and run this code as you go and that you make sense of the output. Any output will appear down here in the console. I also hope that you have moments of inspiration. So if something does come to mind, I want you to code it up and just run it in R. You won't break anything, and the worst thing that would happen would be an error message or a warning message in this box. If you do happen to get stuck at any point, post in the discussions so that way your peers or one of the instructors can help.